My name is Sam East, and I am a radio host and media personality in Toronto, Canada. When I was in school for media, for radio and television, I thought that I was going to be a news anchor. And I thought that was the path for me. I started working in news here in Toronto, Canada, behind the scenes. And it didn't quite pan out for me. I actually got fired from that news job. And I'm not afraid to talk about that because it led me on the path that I'm on now. And much like a lot of people who get fired from a job that leaves you in a position where you go, okay, what am I really supposed to be doing? What lights my fire? What am I passionate about? And it was through that whole experience, a friend said to me, why don't you try radio? You went to school for it. You learned how to do it. Why don't you try radio? And I sort of foolishly at the time said, oh, radio's dying. Radio's obsolete. I want to work on TV. I went for it, made the world's worst demo tape that I hope never sees the light of day again because it was very bad. And a town by the name of Chatham, Ontario, which is about 3 hours from Toronto, saw potential in that terrible demo tape, took a chance on me, and 8 years ago they gave me a chance to be on radio, and I haven't looked back since. I've been working in radio, bouncing to different cities and towns in Canada, and now I'm back in my hometown, have been for the last 3+ years in Toronto, Canada. I think a lot of people, especially when getting into media, have a dream of working in a certain city or for a certain station. And so that inherently comes with a lot of competition. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, but there's a lot of people vying for the spot. But because a lot of the industry is very competitive and feels like it's scarce, there can be a lot of competition. But that, on the other hand, also encourages you to be the best that you can be. Some of the biggest lessons: you can't please everyone. I think a lot of people sometimes shy away from putting themselves out there, whether that be posting a video, trying to go get a spot on the radio or TV or any other industry. People almost psych themselves out from doing it because they're afraid of what people may or may not think of them. And the reality is, you could be the sweetest, ripest, juiciest peach and someone could just not like peaches. So I think about that a lot when you might get a negative comment or a criticism. You take it in stride, and if it's a valid argument, that's something that you use to inform the way that you move in the world. But you also keep in mind that sometimes, despite your best efforts, people might not receive what you're saying the way you want them to. And you can't let that deter you from going after your dreams, especially if you have the best intentions. Representation is so important. I am so proud to be Filipino, and any chance that I can say it on the radio, say it in a video, say it in conversation, I always make a point to make that representation clear because I know how important it is for someone on the receiving end to see themselves represented because it plants a seed of possibility. It plants that little seed that tells you, hey, if that person's doing it, they look like me, they sound like me, they might have the same experiences, similar experiences or upbringing as me, maybe I can go after what I want as well. So I'm so proud to be Filipino and to represent as much as I possibly can and to learn and grow with the community, and just so honored to be a part of it. If you have the capacity to dream it, then you have the capacity to fulfill it. That is something that I go back to a lot when I'm thinking, oh man, that dream is way too big. I don't think I can go after that. If you have the capacity to think it, you have the capacity to make it happen. And that doesn't mean there's not gonna be struggles, there's not gonna be obstacles along the way, there's not gonna be criticism. It's up to you to choose how to navigate past that so that you can work towards the dream that you have in your mind. Sometimes you can be your own worst critic in that sense. So navigating that inner critic is something that is a lifelong journey. I don't think anyone 100% overcomes it. It comes in waves. Sometimes you feel like you're on top of the world, and other days you don't. And you have to take it in stride and keep going. Please keep going. I'm asking you, please keep going. Do not give up on your dreams.